Mega tsunamis are infrequent and catastrophic events that can have a devastating impact on coastal areas. With waves half a kilometer high, mega tsunamis can destroy a city and even wipe an island off the map. Throughout history, these types of tsunamis have caused everything from the destruction of cities to the collapse of entire civilizations. But how do these types of mega tsunamis occur? Which cities are most vulnerable to mega tsunamis? And how could we prevent such events? Stay with us to find out. Unlike normal tsunamis, which are primarily generated by underwater earthquakes, mega tsunamis are the result of extraordinary events that are less frequent but can create half-kilometer-high waves that destroy everything in their path. These events can be underwater landslides. They're one of the main triggers of mega tsunamis. They can occur due to geological instability on underwater slopes, triggered by earthquakes, volcanic activity, or even the gradual accumulation of sediments over time. When a significant portion of land breaks off and falls into the ocean, it can create a massive shockwave that propagates through the water, becoming a mega tsunami that propagates at high speed. Glacier detachment. When a glacier breaks off due to global warming or geological and climatic factors, large portions of ice break off and fall into the ocean, generating giant waves that spread rapidly, causing significant damage to nearby coastal areas. Sometimes the wave generated can detach pieces of the glacier, causing the tsunami to be composed not of only water, but also of large portions of ice as hard as rocks. Thus, a mega tsunami generated by a glacier can have the force to knock down a building without problems. Meteorite impacts. It's no secret that meteorite strikes are sporadic, but potentially catastrophic. When a large object hits the water at high speed, it creates a massive shockwave that can propagate across the ocean, generating a mega tsunami that can affect distant coastal regions and even affect several continents at once. Differences between mega tsunamis and normal tsunamis. So far, we've talked about how mega tsunamis occur, but how are they different from regular tsunamis? Although both mega tsunamis and regular tsunamis are water-related phenomena that can cause flooding in coastal areas, there are significant differences between them. The main difference lies in their size and power. Mega tsunamis are considerably more extensive and more potent than regular tsunamis. While a typical tsunami can have waves several meters high, a mega tsunami can generate waves hundreds of meters high, devastating even the highest coastal areas. Another critical difference is the origin of the event that triggered the tsunami. While underwater earthquakes cause normal tsunamis, mega tsunamis can result from underwater landslides, glacier collapses at sea, or meteorite impacts in the ocean. In addition, regular tsunamis are relatively more frequent. They can occur several times yearly in different parts of the world, especially in seismically active regions such as the Pacific Ring of Fire. In contrast, mega tsunamis are extremely rare and can occur once in centuries or even millennia, but they are far more devastating and can lead to thousands or hundreds of thousands of deaths. Frequency of mega tsunamis. We've said that mega tsunamis are much less frequent than regular tsunamis. But how often does one happen? Due to their catastrophic nature and the extraordinary events that trigger them, mega tsunamis are infrequent in Earth's geological history. There's no set frequency for mega tsunamis, as they are uncommon and can be separated by very long time intervals, from various centuries or even millennia. However, geological and paleoclimatic records suggest that mega tsunamis may have occurred in the past in different parts of the world, leaving evidence of their impact on coastal topography and geology. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Predictability. The factor that makes mega tsunamis so much more dangerous than conventional tsunamis is that mega tsunamis can't be predicted as quickly. In contrast, regular tsunamis can be predicted. But how can you predict a tsunami before it reaches the coast? The key to predicting normal tsunamis is seismic and sea level monitoring stations, strategically located around the world. These stations act as sentinels, tirelessly monitoring for any signs of seismic activity or sea level anomalies. When an earthquake occurs in the ocean, seismic stations detect and analyze the seismic waves generated. An initial tsunami warning is issued if the earthquake is large enough and close enough to a coastal area. This initial alert is crucial, as it allows emergency protocols to be activated and coastal communities to be prepared for a possible evacuation. As the seismic waves propagate across the sea, stations equipped with sophisticated sensors begin to detect any anomalies in the water level and send these signals to the monitoring stations. The data collected by these stations is transmitted in real time to tsunami warning centers, where teams of experts can predict the trajectory, speed, and height of the tsunami. If a tsunami is confirmed, alerts are issued to evacuate the population to safety. Although we can't stop a tsunami, this system gives us valuable time to prepare and minimize losses, from several minutes to a couple of hours before the wave hits the coast. However, this system cannot predict a mega tsunami, as these are caused by events indirect to earthquakes and volcanic eruptions. For example, if an earthquake occurs, it is possible to predict almost immediately afterward whether or not there will be a tsunami. However, these systems cannot predict whether that earthquake will cause a landslide or the calving of a glacier that ends up causing a mega tsunami with waves 300 meters high. The mega tsunami can only be predicted when it reaches a water level sensor, but by this point, the wave will probably be too close to the coast to evacuate people. Although there are very few records of mega tsunamis throughout history, the few we are aware of have caused enormous catastrophes, from the complete destruction of large cities to the disappearance of ancient civilizations. Some of the mega tsunamis recorded in history are the Lituya Bay, Alaska mega tsunami, 1958. This mega tsunami was triggered by a massive rock slide triggered by a magnitude 7.8 earthquake in the Gulf of Alaska. The landslide displaced approximately 30 million tons of material, generating a gigantic wave up to 524 meters high, the highest ever recorded. Fortunately, this event occurred in a remote and unpopulated area. However, it wiped out all the nearby vegetation and caused the death of two people. The Storja mega tsunami, Norway, 8,000 years ago. A massive submarine landslide on the continental slope off the coast of Norway triggered this event. Before the Storja landslide, there was a land bridge known to archaeologists and geologists as Doggerland, linking Britain, Denmark, and the Netherlands across what is now the Southern North Sea. However, this land bridge would have been flooded by the tsunami caused by the Storja landslide. This event would have had a catastrophic impact on the contemporary Mesolithic population and would have separated the cultures of Britain and those of the European continent. Santorini eruption, Greece, 1600 BC. The volcanic eruption of Thera, Santorini, in the Aegean Sea is one of antiquity's most well-known geological events. This catastrophic eruption caused a large part of the volcanic caldera to collapse into the sea, generating an enormous tsunami that traveled to the island of Crete. Many archaeologists speculate that this event devastated the Minoan civilization on the island of Crete. The eruption expelled large amounts of ash that sterilized much of the region. At the same time, the mega tsunami wave would have destroyed a large portion of the towns and the city. Cape Verde mega tsunami, 73,000 years ago. This event is believed to have been triggered by the collapse of a portion of the volcanic island of Fogo in the Cape Verde archipelago. The collapse generated a wave up to 250 meters high that propagated across the Atlantic Ocean, leaving sediment deposits in the Canary Islands and off the coast of Florida. If a wave of this magnitude were to occur today, hundreds of thousands of lives would be lost. Consider that the Cape Verde mega tsunami was 8 times larger than the wave that hit the coast of Southeast Asia in 2004 and killed 230,000 people. Chicxulub impact, Mexico, about 65 million years ago. This is one of the most well-known It is the same asteroid that ended the age of the dinosaurs. The impact of the asteroid Chicxulub is one of the most devastating events in Earth's geological history. This impact, which occurred in Mexico's Yucatan Peninsula during the Cretaceous period, is widely accepted as the primary cause of the mass extinction that wiped out the dinosaurs. The impact generated colossal tsunamis that would have affected vast areas of the planet, with waves that could have reached several kilometers. This event is classified as one of the giant and most destructive mega tsunamis in Earth's history. Cities most vulnerable to mega tsunamis. With everything we have learned so far, we can draw on the main factors that trigger mega tsunamis, such as landslides, glacier calves, and volcano eruptions, to identify some cities in the world that are in high-risk areas and would therefore be more susceptible to being impacted by a mega tsunami in the future. Some of them are Valdivia, Chile. This coastal city in southern Chile is located in a highly seismic and volcanic region, with a chain of active volcanoes nearby such as Villarrica and Osorno. In addition, the area is prone to landslides due to its mountainous topography and the presence of glaciers. If a volcanic eruption or massive landslide of land or ice were to occur in the future, this could trigger a mega tsunami. Juneau, Alaska. Located in a coastal region with numerous glaciers and fjords, Juneau is at risk of mega tsunamis triggered by glacier calvings or landslides due to the high seismic activity in the region, which often causes such events as the 1958 Lituya Bay mega tsunami. Naples, Italy. This Italian city is located near the active volcano Vesuvius in an area of high seismic activity. If this volcano were to erupt on a large scale in the future, it could trigger a landslide that would generate a mega tsunami that would impact the coasts of Naples and its surroundings. Yakutat, Alaska. This small fishing town is located in an area prone to landslides and glacier calving due to its proximity to Yakutat Bay. These natural phenomena would cause a mega tsunami in the future due to the calving of a vast glacier. Wellington, New Zealand. New Zealand's capital is an active volcanic region close to major geological faults. A landslide or volcanic eruption could generate a mega tsunami that would impact the shores of Wellington and its surrounding areas, destroying much of the city. We must remember that this is just an estimate based on a very simplistic analysis. So if you live in any of these cities, you don't need to rush to pack your bags to evacuate. Let's remember that mega tsunamis mainly affect coastal cities. So if your city is very far from the coast or is in a very high place, it's virtually impossible to be impacted by one. Now we want to know your opinion. What other city do you think might be vulnerable to mega tsunamis? Let us know your valuable feedback in the comments of this video.